Hello students, in our previous video we have discussed about the magnetic field due to a straight wire of carrying current So in this we have seen that when we have a wire of finite length, straight wire, and this wire containing a current I in one direction, then the magnetic field due to this finite length of wire at any point P is provided by a formula mu 0 by 4 pi I whole into sine of phi 1 plus sine of phi 2. Suppose that the perpendicular distance of this wire from the point where we want to calculate the magnetic field is A, and the angle made by this perpendicular line with the line joining to the end of the wire downward is phi 1, and the angle made by this line, perpendicular line, with the line joining to the upper end of the wire is phi 2. Then the magnetic field at this point due to this current carrying conductor is mu 0 I sine of phi 1 plus sine of phi 2 A. So this is the simple formula with the help of which we can easily calculate what will be the magnetic field due to this finite length of straight current carrying conductor at this point. So in this, if we find out what will be the magnetic field beside infinite length of wire, so if we take this wire as a infinite in length here and here, then the angle made with the end which is placed at infinity to this point will be equal to 90 degree, that is pi by 2, and this end which is also placed at the other place at infinity, if we join this point to that end, this also makes a right angle at here. So if we take the length of wire as infinitely long, then the total magnetic field due to this current carrying conductor will be expressed as mu 0 upon 4 pi I by A whole into sine of 90 plus sine of 90. So you can easily get sine of 90, that is 1, here sine of 90, this is also 1. So this becomes mu 0 I by 4 pi A dot 1 plus 1, that is 2. After solving it, we get mu 0 R by 2 pi A. This is the simple formula for the magnetic field due to a long, infinitely long straight wire that carries a current, and the magnetic field due to this infinitely length long wire that is taking a current I through itself. At any point the magnetic field becomes mu 0 I by 2 pi A. Okay, so this is all about what will be the magnetic field due to a current carrying conductor of finite length, also of infinite length, and you can solve different types of numerical problems based on these formulas. One thing more, this formula can also be obtained with the help of another rule that is known as Ampere-Circuital law, which can be expressed in next topic, next video. So we omit that here. Now let us start our discussion about the magnetic field due to a circular current loop. Magnetic field due to a circular current loop. ड्यू टू सर्कुलर करंट लूप. सो सपोज दैट यू हैव अ सर्कुलर करंट लूप हूज प्लेन कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एज परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन ऑफ दिस बोर्ड. सो इफ वी कंसिडर अ सर्कुलर लूप लाइक दिस whose plane is perpendicular to the plane of this board. The plane of this board is towards yourself, and the plane of this circular loop is considered in the direction of just right angle with this direction of the plane. Okay, so if we consider the radius of this circular loop is as a, and if you want to find out the magnetic field due to this circular current loop in which a current I is flowing through the loop is at any point, suppose that here is a point P where we want to calculate the magnetic field due to this circular current loop, and if we assume that this is the center and the length of this OP, that is center to the point, is x, then what will be the magnetic field due to this circular current loop at this point? We want to find out this. To find out the magnetic field at this point, we assume our concept in basic terminology, that is in current loop. So we can consider there are two different points placed just vertically, topmost point and also bottom point. So suppose that this point is C and this point is D. So we can take a small current loop at C, and the direction of the current is flowing through this loop will be along this. Suppose that this current element is represented by the symbol XY. And we can also take another current element at point D, whose direction is indicated in this direction, and also this can be expressed as from x dash to y dash. Okay, the current flowing through the D is enters into the plane of the board, and the current flowing through this current element XY is emerging out and just parallel to the plane of the board. Okay, or you can say that perpendicular to the plane of the circular current loop. This is the circular current loop. Okay, so this is the circular current loop, and at this point the direction of the current is emerging out to the plane of this board, or we can say that this is parallel to the direction of the plane of the board, or also we can say that this direction is perpendicular to the direction of the plane of the circular loop. Okay, so if we apply the Bio-Savart law to find out the magnetic field due to this small current element at this point, then first we have to join this to the point P. Suppose that the position vector of this point with respect to this current element is R, and the value of this small current element, that is length of this small current element, is taken as DL. So DL is a direction. If we multiply the DL by I, then I into DL termed as what? This is known as a current element, and the direction of this current element is always perpendicular to the direction of this position vector. That is, if we assume that, what will be the direction made by this position vector of point P to the plane of the circular loop or this current element, because the current element at this point C is emerging outward. It means direction of this is in this direction, and the direction of the position vector is in that direction. So the angle made between these two is right angle. इट मीन्स द डायरेक्शन बिटवीन डी एल एंड आर इज 90 डिग्री. सो इफ वी राइट द फॉर्मूला फॉर द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू दिस स्मॉल करेंट एलिमेंट एट दिस पॉइंट पी, then we get what will be the value of the magnetic field. That will be equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi I into dl cross r divided by r cube. Okay, so in which direction the magnetic field represented by this circular current loop at this point. So if we take the direction of R in this direction and the direction of DL is just in perpendicular to here, then the plane of this DL cross R is lying on this plane. So the perpendicular to this direction contains the direction of the magnetic field. So direction of the magnetic field at this point due to this small current element will be considered in this direction. Okay, and also if we take the magnetic field due to this current element at that point, then if we join this, then this is also vector r, and the direction of the current element is just entering into the plane of the board. So direction of dl and r here makes also a 90 degree, but the direction of the magnetic field at this point to this small current element will lie just perpendicular to the r at this point at here. This is the dB. If we resolve this magnetic field in its direction of the axis of the circular loop and perpendicular to the direction of the circular axis of the circular loop, then we can get it as in this direction and in this direction. What will be the value of this? So first we want to calculate the magnitude of the magnetic field in vertical direction and horizontal direction. For this, suppose that let us assume the angle made by the position vector with the axis of the loop is phi, and this one is also phi because this is symmetrical in both direction. So because this one is perpendicular to this and this one is perpendicular to this, so angle between these two is just equal to the angle between these two. So if we assume this is a hypotenuse because this is the resultant, if we want to resolve it in vertical and horizontal, then this becomes as dB of cos theta and cos phi, and this becomes dB of sine of phi. Okay, similarly we can also resolve this in this two component, and this becomes dB cos phi and this one is dB sin phi. Due to symmetrical condition of this both magnetic field due to this both current element, the value of the dB cos theta is just equal to the value of dB cos theta due to all opposite current element present on each portion of this current loop, so they will be cancel each other. At due to each current element contains the opposite of the another current element on the circular loop, so that the magnetic component of the magnetic field possessing dust in vertical direction will always cancel out, and the net magnetic field at this point will be just equal to in direction of the horizontal, that is in along the axis of the circular current loop. So first if we express this in the theta form, then we get what will be the value of dB. This will be mu 0 upon 4 pi I dl r into sine of the angle between r and dl is 90 degree, so here 90 divided by r cube, sine equal to 1 and r cube. The direction of this magnetic field will lying along this direction. So if we write the magnitude of this magnetic field, this will be equal to mu 0 upon 4 pi IDL by R square. So if you want to calculate the net magnetic field due to both these two current element at this point, then we have found that the net magnetic field is lying along the axis of the circular current loop. So DB net at this point is lying along the DB of sine of phi into I cap. This is the magnitude of the magnetic field and direction of this magnetic field, net magnetic field due to this current element lying along the I axis direction. So our x along the x axis direction or along the axis of the circular loop. So if you want to calculate the net magnetic field at this point, so this will be equal to the integration of the dB sine of phi I cap. Okay, and if we put the value of dB from here, then we get what? Mu z integration mu 0 by 4 pi I dl by r square sine of phi dot I cap. So from here we can easily get what will be the value of the magnetic field. This will be equal to mu 0 as constant, it can be taken from outside, mu 0 upon 4 pi I is, that is current flowing through the loop, is also taken as constant, and r, that is the position vector, r the distance of this point from the circumference, is also constant. And the value of r is what? If the value of the length of the P from O is x and the radius of the circular loop is a, then r can be expressed as x square plus a square or a square plus x square under root. Okay, so this is the value of r. So r square will be equal to x square plus a square. So we can write it as x square plus a square, and it can be taken as outside from integration. And if we put the value of phi, then the angle made by this position vector line with the circumferential point is always constant, so sine of phi is also constant. And the value of sine of phi, if we take sine of phi in this triangle, then we get sine of phi equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is a by r, that is a divided by r, it means under root x square plus a square, and in the remaining term is dl, so dl dot I cap. Okay, so this becomes mu 0 I divided by 4 pi and a, the total power of x square plus a square becomes 3 by 2, because here 1 and here 1 by 2, and the total length of the dl, total length of the dl, that is circumference, is 2 pi a dot I cap. Then from here we can get this pi u is cancelled by this and 2 twice, and a that becomes a square. So the magnetic field at this point becomes mu 0 I a square divided by twice of x square plus a square whole power 3 by 2 I cap. This is the formula with the help of which we can easily get what will be the value of the magnetic field due to this circular current loop at any point or axial point on the axis of this circular current loop. Now we can take two different cases at here. First, if we want to calculate the net magnetic field at any point placed at the circular current loop, so magnetic field at center of the circular current loop, magnetic field at the center of circular current loop. So if we put this point is at this point O, then the value of x becomes 0, So in this case x is taken as 0, so the value of the magnetic field at the center of the circular current loop will be obtained with the help of this formula. If we put the x is at 0 at here, then a square will be cancelled by this square root, and this term becomes a cube, and a cube will be cancelled by this a square, and 1a is remained at here. So mu 0 I divided by 2a I cap. This is the formula for the magnetic field at the center of the circular current loop. Okay. Now, if we take the second case, case 2, in which if we assume that this point is lies on the axial line and this point is lies at very far distance. So this x must be considered as very large and this a can be treated as very small. So this a square can be considered as negligible in comparison to the square of x. So this can be taken as negligible. So this term becomes x square whole power 3 by 2. Here square root and square will be cancel each other. The total term becomes x half cube. So the magnetic field at any far point on the axial line, then this becomes mu 0 by twice of here I into a square divided by x cube I cap. This is the formula. There are two different cases. With the help of these three formula, you can solve different types of numerical problems based on these formulas and the concept using different numerical problems. Okay, take care, thank you.